welcome to DIY Solar and Wind. If you want to make your own electricity, click on the links down below. Today we're at the Kalamazoo Air Museum. I have this plane right here, the North American Texan. I'm trying to get this to work for me, but winging it. I'm going to go ahead and read the description here a little bit. See if I get the whole plane in here, or most of it. You got nice lighting on this plane. The ones out on the other side of this building aren't so good. The lights are different. North American Texan. You can't even tell if you're seeing the plane. North American Texan was considered the best in a long line of trainers that North American Aviation began building in 1935. While the development of the trainer began in 1937, the first production models appeared in 1940, used as an advanced trainer. Its U.S. military designation was 18-6 for the U.S. Air Force, AF, and SNJ for the Navy. The 18-6s were called Harvards by the Canadians, but were also built on license in Australia and Sweden. Pretty interesting. The Texan displayed at the Air Zoo represents the U.S. Navy Training Squadron stationed at the Naval Air Station in Pensacola, Florida. Green stripes around the wing indicate the aircraft is used for instrumental training. Texans and Harvards train almost all American pilots and many Allied pilots during World War II. A total of more than 15,000 Texans were built after the war. Only about 2,000 remained in service in the U.S. These were overhauled in 1949 and continued to be used as advanced trainers. The last British pilot to qualify in Harvard training on March 23, 1955. In some foreign countries, the 18-6 was used as a fighter plane. First flight, 1938. Into service, 1940. Wow, pretty interesting. Thank you. And have a nice sunny day.